So it's 1:24 in the morning and I woke up. I don't know if I can get this right, but it's raining in our hostel and there's water going down and it's all over my suitcase and everything. And now it's getting on my camera. It's what you get for hostel living.
So we went on this Ra-Ra's retreat in Hawaii and we were complete strangers. 10 of us, 12 of us? 10 to 12 of us to begin with. And this, the whole time we were just being completely honest with each other and taking huge, I guess, leaps of faith and like everything, you know, jumping off of a cliff and saying things that were on our mind that we hold back. And I feel like it just gave me a lot more confidence and I feel like I don't have to hide certain parts of me, or I should be a little bit more fearless. So I feel more fearless. That's what I would say I've changed. Saying what I want to say and doing what I want to do is going to help me for sure to express that in my interview. So yeah, I hope so. And I'll let you guys know.
So last night we had an energy healer and she basically just felt our bodies and she knew exactly what was going on. And then we worked together, like I was doing the shift. She was like helping me stay present and like release it, and it was a big shift because it's been stuff that I've been holding on to for over 10 years, maybe 15 years. So, and it was a lot of anger and it was a lot of confusion. Like I was confused why it was like that. And now I'm not. And now I have forgiven the person that it was about. And really, basically, and understood why. And that it wasn't a bad thing. It was just the way that life is. So, I've learned that crying and laughing is release of emotions. So basically, it was a good release. Like I couldn't stop laughing, so I felt lighter and I felt like I opened up space inside myself and it felt really good.
And we keep today.
Yeah, and we keep learning. Like every experience is like, if you are willing to take it deeper, fuck yeah.
It's crazy. It's crazy of just like even just like last night's experience. I was under the impression by hearing, like especially like with JP and I don't know if Sal said anything, but like how you hold on to some traumatic events, and it, I was taking that as like too new agey.
Yeah.
Like I'm holding on to things, but then when we did the SRA, like I was so aware of like where in my body it was uncomfortable, and it's crazy.
Yep.
I don't know if I'm a true believer in all of that, but
how is your hip pain now?
Not right here.
Yep.
And I've never been athletic enough to like know like, oh, this is what it feels like to pull a muscle or strain a muscle, but I would assume that would be the feeling.
Yeah.
So what my perceived idea of straining a muscle, I could have been holding a lot of emotional trauma and resentment, and that was the pain I was feeling the minute she started doing those SRA things. And she would like, I can't even do, but she would just like move her hands, and it was insane watching her do it to you.
Yeah.
That I felt like this just energy just like shoot from like my hip and like up my spine and
And it's as she's told us that it's actually ourselves that's doing it.
Yeah, she said that's what I loved. She's like, I'm not doing any of this. Like, I'm just
triggering it, kind of. Or
kind of triggering it, and also like helping the movements be more fluid.
Mm-hmm.
She's guiding it, I guess you would say she's guiding it, but she's not doing anything. But it still is a little sore, but I was dizzy. I was so dizzy afterwards too. Mm-hmm. And the same thing that happened with you, I started laughing. Like, yeah, I felt like I was stoned.
Yeah.
I didn't cry, but I actually like figured out the source of the pain, at least in my lower spine.
Yeah.
And it's still, there's still a little bit of, I can feel a lot of stuff right here. I don't know what the thoracic region is at.
Drinking the Kool-Aid anyway.
Mm. But yeah, we'll take the bus and figure out where we go today.
Yeah, now we're eating and having some smoothies.
Spark a match and watch the candle burn. The wick runs out and then love takes its turn. On fallen angels and broken sounds, we will last past the final round. It took a while for you to find me, but I was hiding in the lime tree. Above the city in the rain cloud, I poked a hole and watched it drain. In parallel to the city streets, our broken crowns beneath our feet. But as we walk across the diamonds, we know that love is always shining. Save me, love, save me all the time. I wash it down with a simple sip of wine. Toast my glass to all my loved ones, to let them know that the stars, oh, they still shine. It took a while for you to find me, but I was hiding in the lime tree. Above the city in the rain cloud, I poked a hole and watched it drain out. It took a while for you to find me, but I was hiding in the lime tree. Above the city in the rain cloud, I poked a hole and watched it drain out. Yeah. It took a while for you to find me, but I was hiding in the lime tree. Above the city in the rain cloud. Find me, find me.